Good morning, ESM. Today is Wednesday, January 3rd, and today is an A-Day. I am Brandon Kelly, and I'm here with your morning announcements. The theater and music department's auditions for the spring musical Godspell are immediately after school today. Please see Mrs. Borkowski or Mr. Graff if you have any questions. Newspaper Club is holding a meeting today at 2:15 in the library. Please see any advisor if you cannot attend. Now over to Frank and Vika with the national news.
Good morning, ESM. I'm Frank.
And I'm Vika, and we're here with your national news. The CEO of one of Britain's biggest companies and four of his family members were killed in a seaplane crash in Australia on New Year's Eve.
Quote, "We are deeply shocked and saddened by this terrible news," unquote, Compass chairman Paul Walsh said in a statement.
Officials say at least 36 people have been killed after a coach bus plummeted 330 feet down a cliff and landed upside down on a beach in Peru.
A transport official said the bus was carrying about 50 people and six survivors had so far been pulled from the wreckage and taken to the hospital.
Peru's president said it was painful for the whole country to suffer an accident of this magnitude. He sent a message of deep solidarity to the families of the victims.
In other news, Utah Senator Orrin Hatch has announced he will resign. The former Republican presidential nominee Mitt Romney, a vocal critic of President Donald Trump, has reportedly been telling associates he hopes to run for the Utah Senate seat.
The former Massachusetts governor, who lost the presidential race to former President Barack Obama in 2012, called Trump a fraud during last year's White House campaign. Trump hit back, calling Mr. Romney a failed candidate who choked like a dog in the 2012 race.
A Canadian man who was held hostage for 5 years with his wife back in 2012 in Afghanistan by a Taliban-linked insurgent group has been arrested.
According to cited court documents, he has been charged with 8 assaults and several other charges.
Pakistani soldiers rescued Mr. Boyle and his wife, Caitlin Coleman, and their 3 children, which they had while in captivity in October 2017.
Due to the orders of leader Kim Jong-un, North Korea has reopened a hotline to South Korea, almost 2 years after it was disabled on. He said earlier he was open to talk with South Korea about sending a team to the Winter Olympics in the South next month.
Well, that is all for today, ESM. Have a great day.
I'd rather be a lover than a fighter. 'Cause all my life I've been fighting. Never felt a feeling of comfort. All this time I've been hiding. And I never had someone to come on. Oh, nah. I'm so used to shit. Love only left me alone. But I'm at one with the side. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one. And I've been quiet for too long. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one. And I've been silent for too long. Too much and I hate it. I'm so used to being in the wrong. I'm tired of caring. Loving never gave me a home. So I sit here in the silence. I found peace in your vibes. Can't show me there's no point in trying. I'm at one. And I've been